Grade 12 ISC students, today we are going to start with a new prose, that is with a new chapter in the name of B. Wordsworth. The title revolves around a single character in the name of B. Wordsworth itself. And now I know that you must be having a curiosity to know that, sir, what does B stand for? Actually, the person who is B. Wordsworth, who is playing the role of B. Wordsworth in this chapter, he is a fake man. He is a struggling artist who has failed in life. And now in this chapter, he actually falls weak and passes away in the end. So this is a fake name being used by him. B stands for black. And he claims to be the brother of a very, very famous poet, William Wordsworth. So this is actually not done. Why did he do this? What made him do this? Obviously, when we would be going through the entire chapter, you will come to know, and you will even realize his pain, because the chapter is based on a very important theme: pain of an artist. Always remember, always remember, whenever we talk about artists, their future or their career is a big gamble. In case if it works, if their artistic skills, they work, so they will be successful, else they have to struggle. Else they will have to struggle. So not all artists are successful. You'll have to take this into consideration. Do you think that anyone who participates in the dance competitions, singing auditions and all, do you think that everyone will be a lead singer? Everyone will be a lead actor? No, so sorry. Artists have a very, very tough life. It is a kind of tit or tat, do or die. This is what they face. So in this chapter also, you will come to understand the pain of an artist, but he keeps on hiding it. And this is what is killing him from inside. So you need to understand the pain of an artist. No one understands. We only want to hear good songs. We only want to see good movies by these artists. That's it. Who will understand their pain? So B. Wordsworth is one of them. He is a struggling artist. He has not yet been successful when it comes to be a writer. He actually loves to write. So this is the background that I have explained it to you. I'll repeat it. B. Wordsworth is a chapter written by V.S. Naipaul. B stands for black. He introduces himself as Black Wordsworth. He introduces himself as Black Wordsworth, and he claims that he is in close relation with William Wordsworth, one of the famous writers, and you people might have heard his name. But what about B. Wordsworth? Sorry to say, I never heard anyone in the name of B. Wordsworth. So this is about the title. The title revolves around this man. You will come to understand that he lives in poverty. He has not written any kind of a masterpiece. he is struggling. Though he wants to sell his writings, though he wants to sell his publications and writings, unfortunately, I'm sorry to say, he hasn't sold a single piece yet. And the biggest question is that, then how does he earn actually? This is something mysterious. I don't know. Nowhere it is written in the chapter from where do they earn, these artists. Imagine in case if an actor does not get movies, does not get to get do movies for 5 to 6 years, then what will he do? Nothing. So I have already explained the title. Now let's step towards the list of characters. Let's see how many characters are there in this chapter. Character number one, he is B. Wordsworth. Character number two, he is the narrator. I know you people would be surprised that, sir, how can a young boy be a narrator? Yes, he is only the narrator in this chapter, a young boy. In this chapter, you will come to know and you will come to understand that B. Wordsworth goes to meet this young boy who is the narrator of this chapter. He goes to meet this young boy because he knows that this boy loves to write. Any guesses why? Chalo. I have already answered this, that B. Wordsworth went to meet this young boy. Reason why? Because he was a writer. Any other guesses that what could be the possible reason why B. Wordsworth had chosen his house? Any guesses? No guesses. Okay, fine, not a problem. I know you people have not gone through the chapter, so how come you would be knowing? But I just wanted to see that what logic you people apply. Actually, this young boy, he is from a very good and rich family. He is from a very good and rich family. So let's see it with the help of a video. Are you people there? Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I'll show you this video that why did B. Wordsworth actually visit the house of the narrator who was a young boy? There is a reason behind it, because many of this. Now see, we'll keep reading and we'll keep understanding the lines. I already mentioned this, that he is the narrator of the chapter. The story actually begins when the young boy describes about his house. Approximately three beggars came daily at his doorstep. So yes, this proves that he was from a rich family. This is narrator's mother. The second character, the first character is this young boy who loves to write. He writes well. He is the narrator of this chapter. The young boy who is the narrator, he says almost three beggars used to come daily because they knew that they would be getting some or the other thing from this house. And she is narrator's mother, very rude, outspoken, straightforward. And the third character is So these are the beggars, actually three beggars. I already mentioned this. Narrator used to live in this street. So you can clearly see that this is the street and three beggars used to visit his house, which clearly indicates that narrator was from a very good family background. And now I'm going to write the name of this street. The name of this street is Miguel Street. Soon after this, B. Wordsworth. Soon after this, B. Wordsworth enters into the picture, who has come to visit this narrator's house. Not because that these people, see, here he comes. Here he comes. So the young boy greets him and actually questions him that why and what for he has come. He introduces himself as B. Wordsworth. I want a reply from you people. Has he come to beg or what? Any guesses?
No, sir.
Oh
no,
my God. Sir. He's tidily dressed. Yes, obviously. He's tidily dressed. B. Wordsworth is tightly dressed. No one can even think that he might have come for this reason. And the story starts with the description of B. Wordsworth, who had one day knocked at the house of the narrator. And yes, this is Miguel Street. A tightly dressed man knocks at the door. Narrator comes out and questions, yes, how can I help you? What do you want? Because narrator, he was a disciplined boy, not like his mother. You'll come to understand the character sketch of mother later on. And you won't believe he lies in the beginning. B. Wordsworth lies in the beginning, so you can call him as a liar. He tells the narrator that he has come to see bees, B-E-E-S, bees in his compound. So yes, he has lied. Now here, look at this. Oh my God. Boy and the mother who were living in this house in the Miguel Street. They had four palm trees. Look at the size and length. And there, these trees were full of bees. B. Wordsworth expresses that, little boy, I have come to see bees in your compound, in your yard. Now, there is one more question coming up for you people. Do you think that has he really come to see bees in the compound?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Obviously, no. The poor young boy. Poor, ironically. He was scared. The young boy runs to his mother. And informs her that a man who is tightly dressed has come to see the bees in our compound. Look at the way he's screaming. Oh my God, there she comes. Oh, 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 oh. Oh my God. The best part was that the man was speaking good English. If I talk about narrator's mother, she spoke in an unfriendly manner. She spoke in an unfriendly manner that what do you want? The man speaking good English was speaking good English and he again showed his interest in seeing the bees. So look at the importance of speaking good English, students. When he speaks good English, though mother suspects him. What is the meaning of suspect?
Doubt.
Yes. Though the narrator's mother suspected at him, but she allows him just because of his good English. I'm going to repeat everything again. B. Wordsworth is a chapter which revolves around this character. He is B. Wordsworth. B stands for Black Wordsworth. He is a struggling artist. Now I am going to disclose the suspense. Why has he come over here? He has come here to sell. He has come here to sell a very important poem written by B. Wordsworth for 4 cents. And he's a liar. In the beginning, he lies. Why and how? Number one, he introduces himself as B. Wordsworth. It's not his real name, sorry to say. Number two, he says that he is a close relative of B. Wordsworth. This is again a lie. Number three, he says that he wants to see bees in the compound or yard. This is again one more lie. So what is the truth? The truth is that he wanted to sell his poem that he had written on a piece of paper for 4 cents, because he knew that the young boy is also a growing artist. He loves reading. He loves writing. So he would definitely purchase it, because when they can give money to 3 beggars who come to beg, then obviously he would be readily giving him 4 cents. Can you understand the pain of an artist? Look at the struggle that B. Wordsworth is doing in his life. Usko kiska sahara lena pad raha hai? Usko ek young boy ka sahara lena pad raha hai, bachcho. Sochiye, 4 cents ke liye. Look at his condition. Oh, mother comes to know this and she straight away declines it. He's caught. He's a liar. Mother already suspected at him. They both spend time with each other. He comes to know that young boy is also an artist. And look at this. I'll tell you something very shocking. You know what B. Wordsworth is doing? B. Wordsworth is trying to poison the young boy's ears against his mother. He questions him. He questions the young boy. If he likes his mother or not, this is wrong. Look at this artist. In order to sell your poem for 4 cents, you are trying to poison him first. This is cheating. Why would you ask a question to a son? You know why? Because B. Wordsworth, actually, he judged the mother when she spoke to him in an unfriendly manner. He knew that his mother will never allow him to pay 4 cents for the poem. So this is the reason he is doing a kind of a research work. He asks him if you like your mother or not. Bichara pyara sa bachcha bolta hai, yes, I like my mother only when she does not beat me. Oh, is this an indication that the young boy is trying to give to B. Wordsworth that his mother is extremely strict? Le deke, if you sum up everything, B. Wordsworth neither wanted to see bees, neither he wanted to know about his mother. He only wanted to secretly talk to the boy. He wanted to actually come to a conclusion. What does the boy like to do? And he likes to write. He likes to read. This is the point what B. Wordsworth was actually targeting at. He slowly takes out a printed paper. And hands it over to the boy. It is a poem. He asks for 4 cents. Now see this, see this, see this. Look at this lie. क्या लिखा है? पढ़िए जरा कोई. ये लाइन क्या लिखी हुई है? पढ़िए जरा. Look at the lie. समझ गए?
Blackboard word.
हाँ बोलो.
Blackboard word, white word words, my brother.
Now tell me, is it white or is it William Wordsworth?
William.
समझ रहे हैं? So look at what is he introducing William Wordsworth as. He is introducing him as white Wordsworth. He is trying to actually distract him by actually targeting the name of William Wordsworth. So he says that we both have same interest. After quoting few poetic lines, and by saying that, once you grow up, you will come to understand. Once you grow up, you will come to know that poet cries for everything. Which figure of speech? B. Wordsworth introduces him as a good poet. B. Wordsworth introduces Black Wordsworth. He introduces him as the brother of White Wordsworth, indirectly targeting William. And then he says that poets can understand everything and poet cries for everything. What does this line signify? Can anyone tell me? Nahi pata. Achha. Poet cries for everything. He is indirectly trying to describe his struggle in life. His pain in life as an artist. It was better that in case if you would have become an engineer or a doctor, being a poet, look at what he is going to do now. Iska sahara lena pad raha hai, bichara paper ek ladke ko bechne aaya hai. So let's see, what does he sell? The man pulls out a printed sheet from his pocket, which is a poem, and wanted that boy to sell it for 4 cents. Oh, look at the mother's face. Look at the mother's face. She blasted that man by saying that get lost. No need. And he keeps it again in his pocket. But he hopes to meet the boy once again. He wishes to meet the boy once again. So class,